Please watch your step. It's easy to lose your footing here.
Thank you, Rastel. I can't believe how cold the kingdom has gotten.
Yes. The chill has only intensified since we left 3 months ago.
If this continues, the capital will... I hope everyone who has been evacuated to the palace is safe.
Yes. We must hurry.
I sense something.
What is it, my lady?
I'm not sure. I just felt like we were being watched.
Subsided. But whatever it was you sensed has been quieted by the wind. I'm sorry I did not act sooner.
It's okay. Please don't concern yourself with it. In situations like this, he reminds me so much of Drian. Still, that presence I sensed, it seemed familiar somehow.
The air is getting colder. Even with our essence equipment protecting us, temperatures this low are still dangerous. We should enter the palace. Lady Olga is expecting us.
Yes.
Our food supply is scarce. The stockpile commissioned by the Queen is nearly empty.
As things stand now, it may not outlast the cold.
Do you think this winter will ever end? They say Lady Donna no longer receives visions. If she has lost her powers, as the rumors suggest, she has no right to lead us.
Mind your tone. Lady Donna risked her life to travel north and investigate. Even if she has lost her powers, her dedication to her people is without question.
That's not what I meant. I just...
Stop it, both of you. This argument is pointless. Regarding our food supply, we have potatoes stored in the underground sanctuary. We'll ask anyone who is able to bring them here.
Oh, I see. Thank you, Lady Olga. I'll let the people know right away.
Also, I know there are still pockets of survivors in the city. I want you to investigate and tell any survivors you find to evacuate to this location.
Good idea. Anyone who's still out there won't survive the next cold front. My men and I will depart at once.
Good. I'm counting on you both. Lady Donna? It's been a long time. I have returned. I'm glad to see you're safe. You surprised me when you said you were leaving the capital to investigate the Northern Nations. I'm sorry. No matter. What's the situation in the North?
Well, about that.
We should discuss this in private. So, the Northern Nations have been annihilated.
It gets even colder the further north you go.
That can only mean any survivors have most likely migrated south of the capital.
I would assume as much. The surviving Saurians are migrating south as we speak. I hope we all make it through this.
The Southern Nations are not so prosperous, but at least hope can still be found there. The real question is, what should we do?
Right. Olga, we should leave the capital and travel to the Southern Nations. We can even provide what resources we have here as a way of helping.
Your ideas are always so bold. Still, I knew you would suggest that.
So you're saying...
You do have a point, Isol, but let me think about it a bit.
Huh?
Rumor has it you don't receive visions anymore, but you still receive visions. Don't you, Donna?
Yes.
I see. Then I need to think about this very carefully. Let's talk again tomorrow morning.
Olga.
I'm sorry, Donna. I need to excuse myself. There's something I must take care of before nightfall.
Lady Donna!
Rastel.
What did Lady Olga say?
Yes. She'll have an answer tomorrow.
Oh, I see. Lady Olga grew up in the capital, so the thought of leaving must be a very difficult one. In that case, what do we do about our preparations?
I must ready myself as well.
Lady Donna?
It's nothing. Let's prepare as we planned.
Understood. I shall take my leave then, and begin the preparations. Will you be returning to the palace?
I'm going to take a walk around the capital before I return.
What? At this hour? Shall I escort you?
No, I'll be fine. I just need to gather my thoughts.
I understand. Please be careful.
Thank you.
I think about it. Whenever I see her.
Damn it! I'm hungry.
Lady Donna.
Donna, help. Please help me.
I have to pray to the great tree.
Food. Is there any food anywhere?
Thank you. Wake up! Mom!
Hope that everyone in the city is still safe. That's a monolith. Why is this one so large, though?
You finally made it. Donna Eclusia. No, Maiden of the Great Tree.
Just kidding! Hiya, lady! Nice to see you again.
Io.
I'm surprised you came here, considering all that's happened. You're really trying your best to lead everyone to the very end.
It's clear to me now that you're no ordinary Eternian. Are you a warden?
Who can say? Sorry, but you're no exception, Donna. I need to make sure you're worthy, too. Even I can't stop the ritual that's underway in the sanctuary. Here goes!
What?
This is gonna be great! None of the previous maidens ever gathered this many spirits!
Huh?
Yes! You are worthy of facing me, Io, as your final opponent! Don't think this is gonna be as easy as your other fights! Now let's go! Come at me with everything you've got!
Yeah.
I think I won, but where's Io?
Well, this sucks. You were strong enough to defeat my Saurian form. You have surely overcome many hardships to stand here as the final maiden. All right, don't be modest now. Walk forward and examine the final monolith.
Io. The final monolith. It activated. The last record was about the saint who saved people from the cataclysms of the Great Tree.
Thank you.
So this is the final chapter of the lost history of Eternia's founding. I never knew the real history behind the temple. People would be shaken to their cores if they found out about this. But then, who built this sanctuary? And why? There's more. As the people enjoy their prosperity, the threat depicted on the Wall of Truth will one day be lost to time forever. But the threat will come one day, like a bubble that must eventually burst. You maidens who have come to the sanctuary, you maidens who are my successors, you will know this truth and bear it on your soul forever. That is the true duty of all maidens, the reason for their very existence. Until such a day, that the final maiden arrives. This message is for all the maidens of the Great Tree, and...
Well, don't you look surprised.
Io, are you actually...
Looks like you figured it out. Yes. I am Io, the first maiden of the Great Tree. You did a wonderful job overcoming my trials, Donna.
I knew it, but why do you look like that?
This form is just a manifestation of my soul. My power is weakened over many years, which is why I look like a child now. But finally, I'm able to fulfill my duty.
Io, I mean Lady Io. What is your duty?
Lady Io, huh? I don't like formalities any more than you do, Donna. I'd prefer you keep calling me Io like you've been doing.
Huh? Okay.
This sanctuary is where I reveal the true history to the maidens. But when I say history, I don't just mean the past. I also mean the present and the future.
The present and the future?
Yes. For you see, this sanctuary exists to reveal the truth to every maiden of the Great Tree.
Does this mean all the past maidens knew the truth about the Great Tree?
I wouldn't lie to you. You've seen it with your own eyes, haven't you? I've been revealing the truth in this way so the wardens wouldn't notice.
I don't believe it.
Not every maiden could handle the truth either. Some of them cussed me out or accused me of being a heretic. Others just went mad from the revelation. Even so, I wanted the maidens to know the truth. But you were able to figure it out before I even told you.
Why have you been doing this?
The Great Tree of Origins will destroy Eternia. Tomorrow is never guaranteed. Someday, you won't be able to do the things you currently take for granted. The world is a cruel place. At times, it even feels like a fleeting dream. Perhaps the same could be said of people's lives. No matter who you are, everyone meets death in the end. Whether you're a highborn noble or a lowborn bandit, everyone must return to the void of nothingness. Consider every action a person performs in their lifetime, every decision that they make. Do you think they're meaningless? You'll have to face that day too, Donna. What will you think when it finally comes? Will you think your life was meaningless? I shouldn't have become a maiden. It wasn't worth all the suffering. I should have worn my mother's ring and kept my vision sealed away. Was I only helping people just to feel like I mattered? Or maybe you'll think to yourself, I wish I had never been born. Will you regret your life to that extent?
No. I would never think that. All my experiences are the reason I was able to connect with so many people. If even one of those events were different, I wouldn't be the person I am today. I think that's true of Eternia as well. Decisions made by you, royals, and our ancestors, that is our inheritance. That's why we're alive right now. Even if Eternia disappears, or if I disappear, whoever succeeds us will inherit our legacy. So, even if Eternia is on the verge of extinction, I don't think my actions were meaningless.
Wow. I didn't think you'd actually have a response for me. Yes, you exist as you do now because of me. And your existence is proof that I once existed. I hoped your brand of determination would be the thread that tied all the maidens together throughout the ages.
Yo, so that's the reason you've been telling the maidens the truth about the Great Tree.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I was worried about how you'd handle the burden of being the final maiden, but I see I was worrying over nothing.
Thank you for worrying about me, though. Still, Io, even if this world seems like a fleeting dream, no matter what happens, as long as the world goes on, so do our wills. So I won't give up until I'm ready.
Wow, I'm impressed. You know far more than I expected you to. I guess you have your own answers.
Yes.
Looks like there's nothing left for me to tell you. I'll leave the rest to the younger generation. I'm getting too old for this stuff anyway.
Io, I certainly didn't expect to have this conversation with you, but thanks to you, I feel like I can see this through.
Thank you, too. Perhaps it's irresponsible of me to say this, but... Go get him, Donna!
I will.
Lady Donna! Everyone accompanying us is ready. Once you're ready, we can depart.
Thank you, Rastal. Could you give me a moment? We'll leave as soon as I'm done.
Yes, my lady.
Donna, must you leave so soon?
Yes. The next cold front will be here soon. This is just the calm before the storm.
I see. I'm sorry I cannot come with you.
It's okay.
I want everyone to choose the decision that suits them best. That includes the people who have chosen to remain in the capital. Their choice is not a practical one, but I now understand why they have made it.
Olga.
Also, some people still blame you for what happened. It is best for us if I stay behind to lead them through what is to come. Everyone must walk a path of their own choosing, so they can face their final moments with pride.
I would expect nothing less from you, Olga.
What do you mean?
It's nothing. Very well, then. This is not goodbye, is it?
No. It most certainly is not.